we're also going to talk about yung mga fresh grads pala dyan na yun nga, gustong mag-try and then takot sila na what if hindi ako matanggap or what if ma-reject ako. Remember when Tanchong was here, yung first ever may guest tayo, and then parang he said na he attempted to apply 7 times.
Wow.
And then ako, I got rejected twice bago ako na-hire ng company. So, I mean, nandun talaga yun, you will get a lot of no's in life. And the more no's you get, the sweeter the yeses will taste.
Oh, yes!
For me, yun yung talagang experience ko. So, for example, fresh grads ka, so natatakot ka na baka hindi ka ma-hire dahil hindi ka naman confident sa English mo. How will you improve or how will you make yourself qualified sa position? So, let's talk about how to strengthen the communication skills.
Mm-hmm.
Let's have Tony first. Go ahead.
Yeah, so about communication skills, I guess nagsisimula yan sa confidence mo, sa sarili mo. Kasi no matter how good you are speaking English, even, you know, people that we know who really can speak good English, kung walang self-confidence, hindi rin nila mailabas.
Mm-hmm.
So just look at yourself. Kung sa sarili mong wika or sa Tagalog ba, kaya mong express ng sarili mo, that's one thing. Okay na, step one na yon.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so next thing that you need to practice on would be the language na. So, expose yourself to the language. So, paano yun? Manood ka ng movies.
Yes.
Magbasa ka.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? Makinig ka. So, yung mga ano senses mo, lahat lalabas yun. At more importantly rather, yung maramdaman mo rin. So, nakita mo, narinig mo, naramdaman mo.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you'll never know one of these days na encapsulate ka na nung English language. No, and then that's the time that you will start to think na in English. Kasi that's the only thing that for most new consultants or new agents, medyo nagkakaroon ng disconnect kasi they think in Tagalog.
Mm-hmm. And then you translate.
And then you translate it like right then and there. So right, but now, dapat mag-practice ka na to think in English.
Yes, that's what I always tell them. Na when you want to speak in English, you have to think in English or else binibigyan mo ng pinapahirapan mo yung brain mo. Kasi three tasks ang ginagawa mo. You're thinking in Filipino, pinapa-translate mo, and then tsaka mo sasalitain in English. So that's really difficult for you to speak. Like what Tony said, 'di ba? In order for you to learn, you have to get out of your comfort zone. Nung nandoon kasi tayo, ay natatakot ako baka mamaya matawanan ako or
pipintasan ka.
Oh, pipintasan ka, magkamali ako, ganyan. That's part of our culture.
Yep.
Yes.
And yung pinipintasan, so it's also important na yung environment mo supportive.
Supported.
Sa kung anong gusto mo, say sa house, sa bahay po ninyo. If you EOP policy if you want sa bahay.
Oo, di ba? Why not?
Alam nyo, ma-share ko lang yung ano, kasi I have a 3-year-old kid. Hindi kami Inglesero magsalita sa bahay, pero nanunod kasi siya ng mga movies na English. Hindi naman Peppa Pig. Ayan, tapos nagulat kami, hala, nag-i-English siya, ang galing, di ba?
Kasi ibig sabihin, no, na-immerse na sila sa language and that's how they learn their first language, kung ano yung talagang lagi nilang naririnig.
Yes, kasi the language is a skill. Hindi mo naman siya kaya matutunan overnight lang.
Mm-hmm.
You have to practice it. Sa mga learners ko, I always tell them, well, one, kung gusto mo ma-enjoy ka, you watch movies or listen to podcasts na mga exciting for you. Or yung magbasa kayo ng magazine, kahit hindi book eh. Kasi I'm not really reading a lot of books.
So, pero tayo dyan.
Pero magazines, kasi mas makaka-relate ka na in your personal level. Tapos, yun nga, speak as much as possible in English. Hindi kailangan 100% na pag nagsisimula pa lang. Even sa sabihin natin kahit sa jeep or sa bus. Halimbawa kayo, magkasama kayo friend.
Huwag nang mahiya, di ba? Huwag ka nang mahiya. Sige lang, magiging career mo naman yan in the future.
Parang, huwag nyo nang pansinin kung may magsabi, ay, bakit sila nag-i-English?
Oh.
Smart shaming yun.
Oh, smart shaming.
Sa jeep, manong payment.
Where's my change? Mga
ganun. I think it depends on your tone, okay? When you speak in English na yung parang you're not being sounded like konyo. Kasi di ba, some people would like, kung konyo ka, like, or yung iba tinataglish nila, like, why are they not following the batas? I mean, how does it sound? I mean, it sounds like you're just being nag-iinerte.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So, yun yung parang nagiging irritating for me, ha? But, in order for you to learn how to speak English or just to strengthen your communication, ang sabi sa amin ng trainer namin, you just have to remember three letters. I mean, CCP, okay? First is C is to correct yourself. So when you speak, you have to be, actually, you have to be conscious pala. First, you have to be conscious. Yes. For example, mali ka ng preposition. You know correct, na no. In, on, or at yung dapat mong gagamitin doon. And then you correct yourself. The second C. Correct yourself. For example, I was at the elevator. Oh, I was on the elevator. Or I was in the room. You have to correct yourself right away. So conscious ka, and then you correct yourself. And then para... masanay ka talaga, and then para ma-master mo yun, you have to do constant practice. That's how you really learn it.
Yeah, because we are not aware, no, that whenever we speak in Tagalog in our minds, we try to translate it word for word.
Yes.
And sometimes in English, iba yung sense niya eh.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? Parang you cannot directly translate yung isang word and expect the person to like understand it the way you are thinking it in your mind. Kasi diba, merong words that are similar in meaning but not exactly the same.
Yes.
So when you correct yourself kasi, or when others give you feedback, take it as it is and then make it as a constructive criticism.
Yes.
Hindi, don't turn yourself down na, ay, sinabi niya sa akin, hindi na ako magaling mag-English, so hindi na nga lang ako mag-English. Parang, ikaw mismo, you don't believe in yourself, so how can you say that those people will believe na eventually mag-improve ka? So important yon. Whenever they give feedback, be kind and accept the feedback. Thank them for the feedback kasi hindi madaling magbigay ng feedback.
Yes.
Alam mo, ma-offend yung person. Yes. Parang, am I going to say this? Baka nakasalala yung friendship namin dito. Pero si kung nabigay niya yung feedback na yun, ibig sabihin gusto kanyang mag-improve. Diba? Yan naman
that's
yung binibigay
ng... That's a true friend.
Yes.